I made some notes there because in case I can't remember something. No, I turned it off. Don't turn it on. No. And I was talking to Peter Wolf once, and he said, when the Butterfield Band came to town about 66 or 65, around that time. Yeah, you mean? He goes, yeah, I put those guys up in my apartment. I said, Wolf.
You did?
You had the Butterfield Band in your apartment? Yeah. And he goes, yeah, I put them up for the, so they wouldn't have to get a hotel. I put them up, and I said, wow. And he goes, yeah, they scared the shit out of me. I went, wait a minute. The Giles Band has something that they're afraid of. Yeah, dig that? Then there's something bigger than Jay Giles.
Well, weren't Jay Giles a great band? We did tons of shows in 74, 73 on. Jay Giles and Humble Pie. But Jay Giles, they were tight, so tight. Mm. And like really good people as well. Mm. And like they would do that pyramid at the end of every show.
Yeah.
I'm like, well, I don't know about doing that. It's a bit dangerous, but great band.
Yeah.
Great band. Great music.
They were already seasoned professionals when I saw them live.
Yeah.
They weren't kids. They knew what they were. They had been there. They knew what they were doing.
We played with them when I was in Savoy Brown. The first show we did was in Boston, a place called the Boston Tea Party. Mm-hmm. Savoy Brown was opening. Jay Giles was in the middle. Anyway, it was like we played and then we saw the Jay Giles Band. It was like, oh, we got a long way to go.
Yeah, they terrified you.
And in fact, the next day they took Dave and Rod out, Jay and Peter took Dave and Rod out to all the record stores in Boston. So it was.
When I, in 78, we were playing on Commonwealth Avenue at the Paradise, it was called, the Paradise in Commonwealth.
Right.
And Peter Wolf came to see us play. I thought I was going to fucking shit my pants. I said, Wolf came to see us and invited us to his show at the Spectrum the next week. Gave us like 10 free tickets. I thought I was going to fucking die. Yeah. I said, you got to be kidding.
They were good people. Good people.
This is too good to be true.
And you know? Peter was a great, great front man.
If not the best.
Yeah.
He was something hard to push.
Yeah.
You know,
he used to be a DJ, right?
Oh, yeah. He got thrown off the air. He locked himself into the WBCN because they were trying to fire him for the music he's playing. He locked himself in, like in Shawshank.
Yeah.
And they had to come and beat on the door to pull him out of the place.
Yeah. He was great. He's still playing, though, isn't he? Still playing, I think.
I hope so. Last time I saw him, it was a co-bill with him and Steve Miller.
Oh, that would be cool.
It was cool.
Yeah.
It was very cool. Both of them. I said, that's it for me.
Good man.
What?
We're done.
Done what?
Well, we're not done. We're just getting started. Come on, we're just getting started. Yeah. All right.